Now, Fabric Data Warehouse. Copy into column count check. The copy statement enables efficient data ingestion from an external Azure storage account into Fabric Data Warehouse tables. If there is a column count mismatch, rows with fewer columns than the target table have missing values inserted as null, but copy into fails if a non-nullable column lacks a corresponding value. Rows with more columns than the target table have excess columns ignored. Enhancing copy into operations with granular permissions in Data Warehouse. The copy into statement enhances Fabric Data Warehouse by enabling high throughput data ingestion from sources like ADLS Gen 2 and blob storage. It supports flexible options such as source file formats, handling rejected rows, and skipping header rows, ensuring efficient and secure operations even with firewall-protected storage. Introducing default schema changes in Data Warehouse. The ability to change the default schema in Fabric Data Warehouse is now available. This improvement, requested by many customers, aims to simplify database management and enhance security. The alter user statement is used to ensure that each user has a predefined schema context when connecting to the database. Enhance performance metrics and query insights. New features have been introduced to provide deeper insights into query performance. The data scan analysis now enables users to determine if large data scans are contributing to slower query execution. This feature allows for comparisons of similar queries, identification of fluctuations caused by change in data scan, and detection of cache utilization. Preview an estimated query plan available via ShowPlan XML. The preview for ShowPlan XML in Microsoft Fabric Data Warehouse is now available. This feature enables users to generate and view the estimated query execution plan in the XML format, which is a tool for analyzing and optimizing SQL queries. Whether troubleshooting performance issues or refining query strategies during development, ShowPlan XML provides a detailed view of how the database engine plans to execute the query. By offering insights into operations such as joins and data movements, it helps identify inefficiencies and opportunities to improve performance. Query hints in Fabric Data Warehouse. Along with ShowPlan XML, we are announcing the support for some query hints. Query hints in Fabric SQL are optional keywords that can be added to SQL statements to provide additional information or instruction to the query optimizer. These hints can improve the performance, scalability, or consistency of queries by overriding the default behavior of the query optimizer. To use a query hint, the option clause is added at the end of the query, followed by the name of the query hint and its optional parameters in parentheses. Simplifying search and introducing filter in Object Explorer. The search and filter features in Fabric Data Warehouse helps users navigate and manage their data efficiently. The search function simplifies discovery by allowing users to find objects using keywords, quick highlighting matches within the Object Explorer. Open from SSMS and VS Code. Developers can now access their Fabric Warehouse through their preferred client tools. The integration with widely used developer tools has been enhanced to prioritize flexibility and convenience, enabling connections with SQL Server Management Studio and Visual Studio Code. This update allows users to perform data analysis and management tasks using familiar tools without complications. Get status bar to Fabric Warehouse artifact. The Get Artifact status bar shows details like the workspace status bar. On the Data Warehouse item page, you can see connected branch name, last sync time, link to the latest commit. Tooltip support for built-in functions. Fabric Web Editor offers strong tooltip support for built-in functions, improving development experience. Hovering over a function in your query reveals an interactive tooltip with the function's name, parameters, and brief description. For instance, hovering over count shows its syntax and a short explanation. Stay updated with IntelliSense. Our goal is to help Fabric developers write queries with new T-SQL statements in Fabric Warehouse. we've added IntelliSense support for these new features. For JSON, improve JSON support in Fabric Data Warehouse. Copy into, column count check for Azure Synapse Analytics and Microsoft Fabric. Spatial analytics functions. Spatial analytics functions are now fully supported in Fabric DW and SQL endpoints. These functions allow for complex calculations on geographical and geometrical shapes, such as determining distance between points, checking whether a point is within a polygon, or whether the shapes intersect. Previously, these functions were not fully supported, but starting from December 2024, they will be fully supported. SQL Analytics Endpoint Performance Improvement. An update has been released to the SQL Analytics Endpoint to improve query performance and data freshness. Previously, users might have experienced slow select statements and outdated data in their tables. This update syncs metadata changes more efficiently to the SQL Analytics Endpoint, resulting in faster select query execution and data updates. This enhancement aims to provide a more responsive and reliable experience for users. We have a couple of demos for Data Warehouse. Let's check them out now.
The copy into statement is the primary way to ingest data into warehouse tables. It performs high throughput data ingestion from an external Azure storage account, giving you flexibility to configure your data ingestion jobs with source file format options, rejected rows logic, different options for authentication to source data, skipping header rows, and other options. The following two conditions apply when it comes to data validation when using the copy into statement. When a row in any of the source files contain less columns than the destination table, copy into inserts columns with missing values as null. Unless, of course, the destination columns are non-nullable, in which case the copy into statement will fail. Now, when a row in any of the source files contain more columns than the destination table, any excess columns from the source files are ignored. Today, we're excited to announce a new option to the copy into statement, which allows you to check if the column count in the source data matches the column count of the destination table. The new Match Column Count option allows users to force copy into to check if the column count in each row of the source files matches the destination table. This option is currently available only for CSV file types, but we will add support for Parquet in the future. Let's take a look. Here, I have a very simple copy into statement, which reads from my storage account. And I have a CSV file here that has less columns than my destination table. By default, when I run this statement, you see that copy into will conclude because that is the current and default behavior of copy into. So it successfully ingested all of the rows from the source. Now, if I specify the new match column count option and set it to on, it will force copy into to validate if the column count from rows in the source data match the column count of the destination table. So if I run this statement now, you see that copy into fails and gives me a message here that's telling me that there's a column count mismatch. It even tells me which row has the mismatch in which file, right here. To wrap, the new match column count option for the copy into statement allows you to validate if the count of columns from rows in your source data matches the count of columns in your destination table. It adds even more flexibility and control to your data ingestion jobs that use the copy into statement.
We'll get started with mirroring an Azure SQL database at VentureWorks. We'll now go to Fabric and click the item Mirror Azure SQL DB. We'll pick Azure SQL Database. We will enter the connection settings and click on Connect. We now get to choose the data that's going to be mirrored. We have the option to select all the tables or choose specific tables to be mirrored. On clicking the warning sign, we see that all the data types are not supported yet, but will be supported soon. We'll pick all tables and click Connect. We name the destination as Mirrored Adventure Works. We can now click on Monitor Application to view the status of the tables mirrored. We see that the tables have been mirrored and the row count was 450. We now run a select count statement and see that the count is 450. This tallies with the 450 here. Next, we're going to make some schema changes and see that reflected in Fabric. We see our product table here. We're going to alter the table and add an int rating column. We see this new int rating column in our mirrored table. Now we'd like to obtain more granular decimal rating. Therefore, we're going to update the column type to decimal here. Now see the column type has decimal values. We will now truncate this table. Truncate table customer address. We see that reflected in Fabric. Next, we're going to drop table. On refresh, we see that the customer address table does not exist anymore. We will now rename table sales order detail to sales order. We see that the table has now been renamed. Next, we rename the color column in the product table to color code. In the mirror table, we see that the column name has been updated to color code. To summarize, when your application is active, you have a seamless mirroring experience.